What is going on, guys? Welcome, welcome. Today we got a pretty good matchup. Week 4, REQ versus CR, French team. CR, if you guys haven't seen them or haven't heard of them, pretty good. A lot of good players over there on the EU side for CR. I don't get to commonly play against or with any of these guys, but I bet they are tied for first with REQ for a reason. So hopefully today we see a pretty even, balanced game. I don't see it getting too far out of hand, as you know, these teams are both full of veterans. You know, they won their games because of one reason. They know how to play as a team. So imagine to see some pretty good NG bombs here. I'm gonna feel bad for any tankers that are gonna have to deal with this. Imagine Santa's gonna have his hands full. Hopefully REQ can get air dominance started. I don't know. I think Sky Warrior is going to be flying the attack jet for the CR team. We'll see what happens. Just going to wait to get started. Those of you guys who missed it, last week REQ had a really good match against... Who did they face? I can't really remember who they faced. It was PG. Very good match against PG. And you know, they came out on top. They played really well. It was fun to watch. If you guys missed it, some of the REQ guys like to stream during these matches. So if you guys want to get their points of view, go ahead and search in the Battlefield streaming section. I'm sure you'll find it. Or you can stay here with us, Potatoes, and just hang out and enjoy the whole match from a neutral point of view. As you know, as competitive players do, they tend to talk a little bit of trash. But hey, that's all good and fun in competition. Just as long as you got the actions to back up the words, you'll be good to go. A couple maps. It looks like we're going to be playing Rogue Transmission early. One of my favorite maps. It's really going to come down to the two vehicles that there's only one of on this map. As soon as I figure out how to scroll down, there it is. Click the left thumbstick. There we go. The AA gun, which we all know is the most balanced vehicle in the game. I say that sarcastically. And then the attack chopper. Imagine the attack chopper is going to pose more of a threat than an AA gun. But you never know. It depends on who gets their hands on that thing and who can use it well. See what the teams do. But relatively, this is a pretty evenly balanced map. You got two attack jets. I don't know if the attack jet was really a smart idea to be putting on this map. I think the two stealth jets would have been better suited for it. Other than that, though, it's pretty even. And it looks like we're just going to go ahead and jump right on into it. Now we're going to start. Hop in. Oh, and there it is. The glitched camera on the tank strikes again. Santa out here using nothing on his tank, no loadouts at all. He's just going in, just default, just with the tank itself. No ammo. Same thing with Triard here, he's gonna run that as well. Triard's a new addition to REQ, for those of you guys who don't know. No, this is not Triard 1000, it's a different Triard. And Infurious is gonna kill Invader with a quad bike. The unfortunate, this is not a crosswalk, sir. We don't slow down for you here. Sorry about that. Oh my goodness, what a first strike to get knocked out by a quad bike. Poor Invader, rip. He will be missed, but REQ's gonna get an early advantage. No, never mind. Colt is gonna be the attack jet for CR. REQ's gonna take an advantage with that AA gun. Looks like these tanks are really rolling together. Triard's gonna get hit a couple times early. He's gonna have to be pretty careful here. So obviously both the armor's been called out for REQ. We'll see what happens here. I don't know if they realize what's happening. Santa's gonna come around the back side here. Hopefully. Oh, we got a 2-on-1. Triard getting hit again. Getting exposed a little bit too early there. Poking out and taking a pretty open route there to get on the flank. Trying to retreat. And it's like CR's even gonna back cap REQ right here. They're gonna go for an early 3-cap. This is gonna result in a real early burn. I don't know if REQ's really waiting for this. It looks like nobody's going to contest that. They're going to have to go and grab them, but it looks like they're going to start their back cap of their own. So, like I said, we're going to have ourselves a nice back and forth. What it's going to come down to, if they can get this tank down, Diego's going to come up, get a side shot on one of them. The repair guy's going to get knocked out, so now they're going to have to back out. Hopefully, REQ takes advantage of this time. It looks like the attack jet is coming in, or is that the attack chopper? We don't know. But Strady here to contest the back cap. Already lost one teammate. Got a man right in front. Can he get the pick? No, he can't. He's going to miss it. He's going to have to rethink what's going to happen here. We'll see who pushes. Uzi fighting 1v1. Can he get it? No, he can't. Motor's going to drop him and hold on to that back cap and anchor that for his team. Well played. But Defert is going to repair and back his tank out to the back objective. Let's see what happens. But CR holding steady. Palestino trying to get back in the game. He's a little bit out of it. Osuk got a man in front, but he's not going to get him. Bray coming out. Zombie coming out with the peek me. Hide and seek is going to drop him, but he's got one more in front. Hopefully, they'll see if they can find each other, and they do. It's Vitality is going to go down, and it's a 1v1 situation here on the back flag. The last man, and it's going to go ahead. Bray's going to push and wipe him. Great call out. Good team effort right there. Looks like CR's. Oh, they do have the attack chopper. REQ has the attack chopper. This is going to put a lot of pressure on CR's armor. And shots fired out. Coming in with the TV. He's going to get the mobility in. But Igles are coming out. Face Punch is going to have to. The Furt's here. Testing. Oh, trying to wipe his back flag. He's got to be careful going down here like this. He's going to get one. Oh, there's still going to be another one in front. Can they get him? Oh, Palestino's going to go ahead. And Palestino is going to wipe that up, and CR is going to control their back flag once again, but in the process, they have lost their 3 cap, and the bleed is now in favor of REQ. See if they can contest it, maybe get back into the C is being contested. We'll see what REQ wants to do here. They do have the attack chopper, so that objective isn't as important, but it is an easy one to hold. The dish, you can't get any air support underneath the dish. Straight, he's got one to his left. Two or three. REQ's gonna push him. He's gonna have to play hide and seek, but it's not gonna be enough. He's getting picked on the angles, and Igla's support is coming in on the attack jet. I don't know who won that first attack jet fight. I guess we can just look here at the board, and it was Colt. Colt did lose. REQ's gonna maintain that air superiority, which is gonna put a lot of pressure on top of CR, and as you see it, there it goes. Corpus Dre strikes again with his rocket pods. He's going to take out that armor, and now Santa and Tryhard have a pretty easy game in front of them at this point. They got no air support on CR's side. We're going to probably see a little bit of an aggressive push. Maybe they're just going to try and control the back flag for a minute, try and get rid of the rats, and then slowly push up. We'll see what happens, but like CR is going to try and spawn here, committing suicide. They're going to probably spawn on the objective back there on the back cap. REQ to try and get a little bit more pressure on him. Igla support going out, trying to get him. I don't know what that's going to do. He's going to be way too far out of range. But the Igla strat is real. And in front, Zombie runs out of ammo, but he's going to take out the G18 nice and calm. Get that pick. Here for his team. Here we go. Let's push on the Charlie objective for REQ and see if they can transfer it into something positive here. They got both armor and air support. This should be a relatively easy cap, but they are losing their back flag. This is though they're just going to give up on it. I mean, at this point, with four people from Creative sitting on Delta, that's four less people to deal with on the objectives. You have air support. Might as well go for the other objectives. Why not? Motor's got one in front, but he's not going to win the gunfight. He's going to lose it. Kinguin getting the pick. Long distance on Motor. Almost looked like those shots were going to be good, but Rexy up here, the inner rat, staying silent for his team. They're going to squad bomb it. The call out goes down. They have been found. Can they hold it, though, is the question. Let's see if we can jump right back into him. Going from the Creative side. If I can switch over there. Well, just can't do it. It's just too difficult to switch between players with the thumbsticks. If I had a mouse, it'd be a little bit easier. Motor got one to his right. Sees him. Can he get the pick? Yes, he does. Kinguin's going to go down. He's going to get revenge on Kinguin, but Furious is going to pick off Motor. Comes a one-on-one situation, and it's not going to happen. Putin, never mind, two-on-one. But REQ's still here. Oh, he knew he was coming, and Putin's going to get put down. Putting around, got another one in front. Didn't get the pick though. Oh, Motor did. Never mind. Motor with the backup. The tank's gonna push around here. CR with an overwhelming three objective cap right now. REQ's got a lot of support. It seems that they're having a little bit of trouble capping these objectives. We need to play a little bit more aggressive. I don't know if they're playing passive or something, but here comes the chopper. This tank is just going to feel the explosions just all day long, and it seems as though Porpoise is still up in the Fantan. Getting hit by the attack to Colt coming in with the strafe. What a clutch play for his team. They needed that badly, but the REQ still holds the cap on Charlie. And Igla support is real, and Corpus is going to go down. CR with overwhelming support for their ground team. Just absolutely coming in the clutch right there. Great pick by Colt to get rid of that attack chopper. And then right back at him is the Igla. Igla Warrior strike again. Sky Warrior here on the objective by himself, but he does have armor support coming up. Defert's up there helping out his team, as well as another person. Gonna put a little couple mines on the objective, it looks like, or not. Corpus is gonna stop that right now. Turbo Putin, however, still holding on to the objective. Got one in front. Can they get him? Yes, he's gonna go ahead and pick Fatality. Getting that ugly open field spawn. REQ, though, coming in late with a 3-cap right here around mid-game. Coming at the 200 ticket mark. They're going to get this 3-cap, possibly, but CR putting a huge offensive right here. They're going to have to... This is the battle of both teams. Whoever wins this objective is going to either hold control of the lead or lose it. So CR's got to respond to this, and they are there. Anchoring. The infantry gameplay right now is absolutely amazing. Face Punch trying to get a pick on. Can't get the pick. Does get the suppression man behind. Can he get him? No, he doesn't. Colt's going to jump out of the jet to help his team. And Shots Fire's going to go ahead and knock him down. Here comes REQ still on the cap. He's got one in front. It's not going to happen. Paulus Dano's going to pick him with the CZ. But not before Vitality has his boys back. He's, I got you, man. No worries, bro. You got melted, bud. But I got you. I'm going to have to get rid of this rat that's anchoring. But in the meantime, CR is back capping, and they have 3 infantry on that objective. Face Punch with a 1v1. Don't know he's on top of the ditch. Actually, he was just spotted. Maybe they know, maybe they don't. They do. They have to know he's on top of the ditch. It's a 2v1. Here comes the 1v1 now. Trying to shoot through the hole. Not going to happen. Whoever's on top of that ditch, he's going to have a 1v1. Furious is going to get picked at distance by Rexy. Rexy with the clutch pick right there, and now we have ourselves another stalemate. 2v2 objectives. Like I imagine, these teams are going to be going at it. Invader in the AA gun's going to get pounded. Going to have to deal with this attack jet. He's got passives on, I believe. Or is those Heatseekers? Those are Heatseekers. He's going to keep them at bay, change positions here. Probably going to look up again here shortly for the next strafe. See what happens. The Fihuan. Here it comes. Rocket pod's inbound. Does he have AP? Yes, he does. He's going to get another Heatseeker off. Get that rep in. It's pretty much a never-ending duel with pods at that point. Pods, you're just never really going to be able to get enough damage before he gets back in the A-gun and locks you again, because you got to restrafe pretty much immediately. It seems as though CR is going to go ahead. Their infantry is just moving together, getting objectives back, and not wasting any time. See if Tryhard, how he deals with this energy bomb he's got. Oh, but he has help from Santa as well. Santa coming down to back up his buddy. Wolf Armor, they're going to trade shots here. GGAP says Santa, thank you. Well played. Thank you for hitting straight through it. And here we go in the Doge fight. Colt versus Corpus. Seems as though Corpus lost the last one, or maybe he won it and got taken down by Igles. Seems as though the switches are going to come into it, and there goes the ECM. Got a little bit of help from the AA gun. It's going to be a tough dogfight for Colt. He's going to get hit straight through ECM. GG Dice, well played. Have a nice day. Corpus is probably going to finish that one off relatively easy with 22 health. Jump in with Frontal right here. He's going to try and get a shot out on Santa. Doesn't. Locks it with the AP. Misses his second shot, but does take one in time, but he's gonna rep that one out. It's gonna go right back to the 1v1 stalemate. Shots is waiting up top for that tank to push. Not gonna happen. Still staying as a rat. There are mines up here, so Santa's gotta be careful unless Shots is gonna point him out to him. He's got a 2v1 whole tank caught in the same area. If they do not have air support right there to help them out, they're gonna get blasted, and here it comes. Corpus coming in with the strafe. Defert says, this is not worth my time. I'm out of here. They gotta back out immediately and start repping. But now he is out in the open. 61% health. The armor's got to take advantage of this air support here. Santa going to push up immediately. Got help from the AA gun with Invader. Here comes the Furt, and he's good. He has no AP. Oh, yes, he does. He does have AP. He's going to try and get underneath some shed here. Hopefully block some of those rocket pods. And on a nasty head glitch right here, DeFertz. I don't know if DeFertz knows that he can. He's trying not to give away his position. I think he's going to wait. He is. He's going to wait and play this objectively. Santa sees the chopper getting up, but that's not going to happen. Face Punch is going to knock that down. Meanwhile, he's going to take a hit here. First, got to be careful. 26 health. This tank has to stay alive if they want to contest this objective. Meanwhile, Santa is getting Engie Bombed. First, getting it. He's getting hit as well. He's got one more hit in him. I don't know if anybody's going to push this flag and hit him. Somebody needs to take out this tank. It's a crucial part of the game. But DeFertz is still... Oh, now he's going to go down. Santa gets the pick, finally. Doing a great job of trying to stay alive. Trying to stay silent right there. But in that position with that much health, you kind of got to push up. You kind of got to do something. You got to make something happen. You got to get some shots out. It seems as though you've just given up on life. Well, it's Yosuke here, holding it down. Facepunch picks up a nice two-piece on Sky Warrior Furious, but he's going to go down as well. Shots fired up, he's pushing up, trying to get this chopper. Going to make a play for it. Meanwhile, Frontal on the back flag. Their last objective, CR, is dwindling here. Light is fading. They're going to have to pull something out of the hat. Frontal going to get a few reps. Trying to stay alive in this tank. They need this armor alive. They're going to have to make a push for Charlie or Bravo, one of the two. Not Charlie, way too much up top, but it looks like they're going to start trying to hit away at it. Corpus got to be careful as well. Lots of Iglas out on that objective. And CR looks to be surrounded. The trades out in the middle of the field are real. They're going to have to try and push up there. It's almost impossible. REQ getting a surround right now. Exactly what I was talking about earlier. Are they going to play it passive? Let CR come at him, maintain control of the back flag, get the wipes, and then slowly push up and get a surround on these guys and hopefully get a wipe. And it seems to be working. RQ putting up a huge line of defense here. Both tanks pushed up underneath the dish. Not a whole lot for CR going on, but they did get a couple rats through to the back flag, and here we go again. Back with the back cap. RQ just seems to not be able to wipe these guys. CR doing what needs to be done, trying to get this burn back in their favor, but REQ holding on to a 20-ticket lead right now, possibly going to extend it a little bit more, but Face Punch and Family gotta be, oh no, Strady trying to get the clutch angle off, but it hits the roof. He is in a building. Didn't happen. Face Punch got away with one right there, and that was a golden opportunity to get rid of that chopper. No ECM, a double Igla out on it. In the meantime of the back cap, REQ has capped the back flag of CR. Now, this is an interesting play because they're going to have to do a little bit of something, but with both air vehicles up, both the chopper and the attack jet, it's almost impossible to maintain control of any of these objectives. Let's see if we can jump in with anybody. Nope, Furious Mick got picked. Just cannon around here. Marco Baz ratting out, holding on to Bravo right now. Know there's a push coming, but the tank responds. Tryhard coming down here to help his team. Diego on the offensive here, trying to put a little bit of pressure. Whoever's down there on Bravo. It seems as though Kingwood might be down there with Motor. Motor gets Motor on the pick. See what happens. Face Punch, getting hit by an angle. He's gonna have to repair relatively easy. What a rat spot by Invader, sitting all the way outside. Just trying to maintain. Furious Mick get a pick on Diego as he's running up in the open. Diego had no chance, gets melted. And CR looking to hold on to this back leg. It is their only hope at this point. They only have about another 20 tickets before they need an objective to contest this lead. Go up by 100 tickets, but that's easily burnable with a 3 cap. I don't know where they're going to get it from. Things are looking... A wild straw from Kingwin is not going to happen. Trying to anticipate that tank's movement, but he didn't move at all. So that's going to go out. And using the Bay 91, I like the choice. I like the choice. Well played, Mr. Kingwin. We'll applaud you on that weapon choice. It's the pick he needs in the open. He's going to push for Bravo. Santa, meanwhile, wondering what to do. What is going on? And just in time, CR doesn't really have time to play around here with these tanks. They're going to have to get on this objective if they want to survive this match. If they want to drag this out a little bit longer and give their infantry some time, they're going to have to push this flag. But get shot in the back. His frontal, he's got a 1v1 going on. He finally gets Diego, but he's going to get bombed by RPGs and everything else. It's not going to happen. Once you get that 50 hit on a tank, it's pretty much GG in a competitive scenario, because that continent, people are going to the sharks, man. I don't even need to say it any better. I mean, Shark Week, we've all seen it, man. Blood goes in the water. Seals die, right? Well, it's just, there's nothing you can do about it. Warp is wondering. Enjoying the view up there. Not a whole lot of opposition. He's got a lot of help from that chopper. Makes things a little bit easier, you know. Gotta give a shout out to Colt, you know, trying his hardest out there. It's just not much you can do in a 1v1 scenario in the jet when you're also getting blocked by the AA gun and the chopper. So shout out to him for going out there and just trying to keep Corpus at bay. But REQ's teamwork was just too strong that match. It seemed like coming there in the late game, they really got a grip of all the back caps and all the infantry that CR had to offer. They really got a hold of it, started to figure out what was going on. They found where the bleed was coming from. They got the spawns. They figured out the strategy. And REQ did exactly what I thought they were going to do early in the game. Play passive. Don't overextend. Play safe here. We got a lot of tickets to work with. And eventually, they got the 3-cap they needed and switched the game right around 145-0. CR, though, coming out really strong. A lot of back caps from them, a lot of counter caps. It was extremely even there through the early and mid game. And just keeping the jet and the attack chopper, the play by Colts with the attack jet coming in right off the strafe with rocket pods, taking out the attack chopper to keep deferts alive in the tank as well as frontal, and making sure that they had tanks in the mid game was huge. And then Igla support on Corpus right away, taking him out right after that, was a huge play by CR. Got to give a credit to them. They work well as a team, so I imagine we're going to see a little bit of the same thing. Might see a little bit more of a closer game here. I don't think it's going to be 145 tickets to zero again. As we saw at the beginning of the game, the last round, CR came out really strong. They got that early 3-cap. They played extremely aggressive. It's just, we'll see if they can hold it this time. RQ does still have their hands full. Can't sleep on this one at all, by any means at all. Even though you're up three digits in a ticket lead, you gotta come out and do exactly what you did last game. You gotta replicate it. You gotta be consistent. Can't sleep. Gotta come out hungry. So we'll see what CR does here. Little trade inside. Excuse me while I take a drink of my coffee. Wipe it out of my mustache. But I must ask you guys a question. I'm gonna throw a straw poll up in chat if you guys would be so willing to take this straw poll. I'm gonna ask you guys, think about it. Who do you guys want to win? Who do you want to win this match? Both these teams are in first place. Keep in mind, both of them undefeated in the ESB league play season 4, I mean, you know, season 6, week 4, excuse me, getting my words mixed around. Who do you guys want to win? I'm going to throw a poll up in stream. Then please, if you guys would, go ahead and take it. I'm going to go jump in with somebody. Jump in with Tryhard. Well, let's go jump in with Furious here. He's been on the back caps for a while. Been playing pretty well. Definitely holding it down for his team. So if you guys could, there it is. There is the straw poll. If you would please vote, your votes will show up on screen. Please click that link and vote. Check it out, ladies and gentlemen. Please check it out. Let's get a little bit of opinion in the chat. Let's see where everybody's sitting at. And Face Punch. His entourage are going to be up here playing hide and go seek. Who can get the picks? It's a one-on-one situation. He does get the spot. He's got one in front, two in front. Doesn't get the hits on any of them. And holy Moses, that guy was moving around really fast. He's got one underneath the dish. Gets a little bit of help from shots right there. now we got a two-on-one situation, but no, they're gonna cap this out. CR knows this chopper team is, this objective is huge early game for them because they had to deal with the chopper all game last game, but it looks like CR's got an overwhelming force up there on Delta. I can get up there with them. There it is, frontal. Up there right now, shots getting a small off on Furious, but here comes Santa, the call out go down, and here comes the armor. A little bit of help, these guys are gonna be in over their heads, and Fatality pushing up on the side, and then Santa finishing it off. CR going down hard on that objective, but hey, gotta get control of these vehicles. They got the AA gun again. REQ made a huge play for Bravo, get the AA gun, get ground control, get Eric's superiority, and then get the chopper up. Great job by REQ, knowing what's important on this map. Meanwhile, Corpus here, gonna have to go into some scissors, as he looks like he is in the dogfight of his life at the moment, if I can get a shot. Oh no, Heatseeker's going out, and it looks like Corpus is right behind CR's pilot, but not before he's gonna go into a corkscrew, and it's not gonna work. Unfortunate, got a lot of help. Not a lot of help. Give a shout out to Colts again. He's got to deal with a lot of opposition right there. The adversity is real. Everything's against him. The world, not even the clouds want him to be up there right now. It's a tough place to be, you know. And REQ here fighting for their double cap. They do have a little bit of a ticket lead right now, even though they haven't had a bleed. It looks like they're outslaying at this moment, and they are. And here comes the back flag cap by REQ sitting up on the roof. Automated front. I wonder if Fatality is going to try and go for that long shot. Going for the Happy Gilmore right there. It's just a 400-yard drive with an M4, man. You can do it, even though they nerfed that gun recently. Both sets of armor on Delta Flag, trying to decide what to do with this back flag. What is going on? Where are they? Do you guys see them? No, I don't know. Got some guys to our right. See what they can do. They're going to be wild with Rexy on the top there being a rat. But REQ's got problems with rats of their own. Going to have to call the exterminator. So Invader and Santa and the chopper are all dedicating their attention to this flag because they know they have the other flags. One cap. Nothing really contesting them. CR would like to see CR possibly just go and try and contest them and neutralize those top flags just to get a little bit of reaction from the armor of REQ. Possibly see if they can make it rotate to a different side of the game. Excuse me. God, the hiccups are real. And REQ taking an early 3-cap right here. And CR losing a lot of their map control right now. But they do have one rat left. But the call out is there. Triarch does spot him with the thermal. See what happens. They're gonna have to figure out how to get rid of him. But Furious Mac committing suicide as he hits his head too hard on the wall there. Or he doesn't. He was in his menu. I was just thinking maybe he ran into the wall. You never know. Oh, there it goes. Now they found the rat. Sky Warrior now knows where they're at. They gotta be careful, but he does get picked for re-peaking that motor, jumping out, destroying him real quick, making him pay for peeking too early. There goes the parachute, but the Igla support's just gonna go out anyway. Gonna try and help out his buddies. See what happens. Motor's gonna get picked though, dropping down, gets a 3v1 and gets melted. CR looks to have control of their back flag. But Turbo knows somebody's in front, but it doesn't matter. Fatality, it's already too late. He picked up a two-piece. And here we go with the back cap. REQ maintaining a huge. Just not the same CR team we saw. I don't know what happened. REQ's got a huge advantage right now. They got all the air vehicles. These tanks are just gonna be feeling the pods all day. They gotta get underneath the dish and get some, just start staying alive and pull some guys off the objective. They gotta get this armor and keep it alive here. I don't know if trying to cap this objective with armor is really the smartest thing to do out in the open. Hey, you know, you do what you gotta do. They're looking at a 4-cap right now. This is their home objective. They're gonna receive an NG bomb. Stradium King one here, gonna try and work it out. We'll see what happens. He's got help from his armor. He's got some infantry pushing him, but these TVs, the TV dusts underneath the tank, but he's gonna start getting hit by these pods and the tank as well. He's very vulnerable right now. 52 health. Shoutout's gonna go down, and here it comes. 17 health, more pods coming in. Can he survive? I don't think so, but the infantry doing a great job for CR. I'm just gonna point this out right here. Saves this tank. This is what saved the tank right here. These guys with Igles. This infantry doing what needs to be done with the chopper. They kept him off him for just enough time. Find out who this rat is under a huge amount of fire. He can't do anything. It's gonna be Yosuke. Gonna try and stay alive. Great team play right there. That is how you sell out right there. Keep your armor alive. Allow it to get away for a second. It's too bad that he couldn't, because Corpus came right in right away with the rocket pods. Made sure that tank went down. Great play by CR though. Absolutely fantastic. And the Jihads are coming out. Here comes Polistano. He's had enough of this armor. It's enough of it. But he's gonna get spotted, and Santa's gonna say, "Not today, buddy. You're not gonna happen today." I've seen that happen on PC too many times. Santa and that PC community also tanks on there as well. He has to deal with a lot of jihads. Plays against a lot of Brazilian teams, a lot of European teams. The jihad is nothing new to him. Synthic as well like to jihad him a lot. You guys don't know about Santa. He does stream himself. I'm gonna throw a shout out to him. He does stream from time to time. He plays on PC, plays on console. Most of the time, he just streams PC. So, good luck catching him on a good day if he's ever streaming. Go ahead and check him out. Oh, REQ still on the roof here, holding it down. Sky Warrior's gonna get a pick on Motor, but Ray is gonna knock down Kingwin, and Furious is gonna retaliate right away on Zombie and knock him down as well. But they still have one more person anchoring on that back objective. A key strat. Take advantage of and take notes. Anyone who is looking to join a team or thinks that they want to join a team, anchoring will find it for you. One person anchors on an objective so the whole squad doesn't get wiped and you don't have to repush. So if you have four people on that back cap right there, one person stays alive, and that's Rexy. Has been designated as the anchor, and he's just going to stay alive on top of there as long as he can to allow the constant spawns, the constant pressure, which now has CR looking at being based. Things are pretty grim right now for CR, but you know, it's just not their map. This map is kind of one-sided. They didn't get the AA gun right off the spawn. They didn't get the attack chopper, so they're constantly having to face, you know, insurmountable odds there. Pulse is by himself pretty much the whole time. He's just getting locked by the AA guns, getting locked by the chopper, then he has to dogfight Corpus all at the same time. And as we all know, Corpus is a really good dogfighter. Sky Warrior getting shot in the back though, tried to make it around. Shots is going to take him out. Possibly got a little bit of a grudge there with the Igles, but it looks like CR using smoke now, trying to push up on top of the dish and bomb Santa here. But Santa is using thermal, but he doesn't see the guy coming up on his right. But I don't think it's going to matter. He's only got a repair tool. He is getting bombed by the repairs, but Santa is just having a field day. Picks up a two-piece. Sky Warrior trying to drop down the middle, but he's going to drop right into another tank, and Tryhard's just waiting for him. It's a trap. There's just nowhere to go. It's a slaughter. Oh my goodness, the poll is still up as well. Thank you guys for voting. It's just overwhelming right now for CR. Gotta give them all the credit in the world though. They are fighting as hard as they can fight. Great plays. There's not much they can do right now. You know, it's just the air superiority is overwhelming. Frontal trying to throw up a last minute montage, and just not gonna happen. And we see REQ walk away with one here pretty easily. They maintained a huge majority of the objectives. CR just, there was just not much they can do. Once they lost that AA gun, that was pretty much it. And there you go, map control. I mean, it says it all right there in the board. I mean, there's not much this CR can do. There's nothing you can do. Chopper and attack jet, and you guys can't do anything. Igles, at some point, you gotta make a switch out for Igles and try to get ground control. I mean, it's just, you know, only have a couple Igles guys. I think they might have over-dedicated too many soldiers, too many infantry to Igles, and they literally had nothing to bomb the tanks with. The tanks were already up against the air. They didn't have any support on the ground, really, with RPGs. No RPG suppression on the armor. And as you can see with Santa, 22-0. He didn't really have much opposition right there on the ground. I mean, we gotta pick something here. You know, shout out to CR for doing their best with that. You know, it's overwhelming odds. I understand it, but I mean, at some point we gotta make that switch. Just a little. That's just my opinion. I think maybe they should have switched a little bit earlier off of the Igles. I think they might have seen a little bit better results. They kind of got suppressed. You know, the armor last game, the first game on Rogue Transmission, CR was doing an amazing job keeping the armor at bay, constantly making Santa work. It's just about, you know, suppressing a little bit. They survived for a decent amount of time, but eventually the air was just too strong. Requiem's gonna go up 1-0. I think on this map, judging by how successful CUR and REQ, you know, taking their successes and their positives from that match, I think this is more of a map that CR is really going to have a chance on, because it's even. One tank, one little bird on each side. You don't get the AA gun. You don't get the attack chopper. So, I mean, really, it's just going to come down to this is a spot where Igles are going to help, because you only have one air vehicle to deal with. So that air vehicle is going to have to deal with a lot more locks than having to spread out your locks to the attack chopper and the attack jet. You can only focus it on one vehicle. So we're going to see a little bit of a different gameplay here, possibly from CR, maybe even a different outcome. I mean, this is with their infantry, I think their infantry goes well. I think they're up to par against REQ's infantry. And as we've seen before in games in past, REQ's infantry is very strong. They went up against a really good DMI infantry on lockers. Great games that I got to shoutcast back and forth. And I mean, DMI's made their name pretty clear. They're not to be, you know, underestimated. They definitely made their they made their name. So, and also PG last week also doesn't have bad infantry. They also have really good infantry, and REQ's done a great job in winning games in the mid game and the late game with their infantry. They really focused up and they really just worked well as a team. They support their armor and their armor supports them, and they just go hand in hand. So we'll see what happens here. I think CR is going to pull it out, possibly with the infantry game here. I think they're going to maintain possibly two objectives for a good majority of the map and possibly get a good ticket lead. So we'll see what happens. I think CR is going to put up a little bit of a fight here. This is going to be a tough win for REQ. Just predicting, my opinion, I think they're going to come back. So we'll see what happens here. We're going to have a couple roster changes and then get a little bit of communications between the leaders and have everybody figure out when we're going to go. Give me a second here. I got to check an email. Gonna jump right into it. The first flying the scout, and here comes the bomb. Megatron switching over, but he's just gonna get destroyed by an Igla. The double Igla just absolutely melted that chopper. Oh my, I've never seen a chopper get hit so hard in my entire life. That was just a team effort to absolutely obliterate anything in the air. My Lanta. Oh my Lanta. Wow. Well played by REQ, and they take this. They take an early two cap. They got the tower and they got Charlie. Defert's kind of walking into a wall of fire right there. He's going to be 30 health. He's rocking the Swagnum. I like it. I like the choice of the 3X Scope Magnum. But he's going to get picked by Ace Time. Time coming in. Timmy, try hard. Timmy coming in with the M4, getting the pick. Easy. The call out goes down. And here we are. CR's looking at a little bit of a deficit early here. They got some tickets to work with, though, so they should have plenty of time. Meanwhile, that MRAP, that ZF-B05 motor in there, just holding it down, getting a two-piece right there, but he's going to get Angie-bombed. Going to jump out, possibly, and get some kills. He does get one. SMT, ouch, is taking some fire. He's going to have to go up the elevator, but he can't get to the button. It's on the other side. It's unfortunate. Ace time, getting the pick on him. Frontal's going to play a little bit more passive in this armor. He's going to sit back and make sure they have control of that back flag. And we'll see what REQ does here. See if they decide to push or if they decide to hold. Majority cap to get a good lead. While Defert's trying to sneak behind everything, but I don't know if it's going to happen. They're going to have to switch. Oh, baby. Here come the locks. And the chopper does know he's there. This sneak, I don't see this going well at all. I don't see this going well for CR. They've already been spotted. Oh, never mind. He's going to lock and make them go away. Oh, my goodness. Megatron almost dipping the chopper out right there. Got to be close. He's getting locked. High Aegis. And ouch, is back on the offensive. He's going to get shot by a canister shell. Or medic. There's nothing you could do. And here it comes. This is exactly what I was waiting for. CR putting a huge back cap on right now. Now Santa's going to have to deal with a 4-on-1. It's going to be NG bombed here. Here come the SMAWs and the RPGs. Yeah, he's going to have to deal with six CR players on the back flag right now. Two RQs jumping in to contest this. No rage. He's going to come in. He's got a frag. He's going to make an eject. Here you go. Is he going to get the pick? I think he's already dead. I think there's anyone over there. He didn't get a hit marker with that. I think they're dead. Yeah, that's going to be it for REQ defending that objective. Put the backwards mines! Oh my goodness, Zombie getting the... What a legendary mine placement right there. That was fantastic behind the tank. He had already pushed up. Wow, good mine placement right there. It's unfortunate for CR, but there's nothing you can do about that if you don't look for him. And here we go. CR's going to keep... He's got a little bit of a wait here, possibly about a minute wait in the game. Up to 15 minutes, they'll have an even ticket count right here if they hold this two cap. I think they got plenty. Santa's just going to go down right here. He's got no chance. He got mobility hit. He's going to get bombed. Palestino, however, is going to get picked by Ace Time. Ace Time trying to get in the corner and reload. It's not going to happen, though. Street's going to shut it down. And CR still having 5 to 6 people here on this objective. REQ's looking at trying to get another objective. They're going to have to negate this double cap, which I think they will. They're going to try and back cap themselves. Only one person here for CR, and Diego's going to go in and find him sitting in the ice cream shop. I think I said shop. I mean, it's about the same. I mean, it sounds relatively similar. I mean, I can get away with it, right? Guy up top, Diego's just gonna sit down low, nothing's gonna happen. Marco Boss is gonna wipe Kingwin, get him off that objective. Now, as we see CR dedicate a lot of people on this objective, at some point they're gonna have to leave. You can't win just by holding the back flag alone. Straighty getting picked by Santa. Santa coming out hot. He's coming back for a little bit of sweet revenge. Well, now they're gonna have to deal with Medi in the chopper, and there goes Putin. He's gonna get picked off, and only two people left here for CR. He does see one to his left. Katie gets Santa. Don't know if it's gonna happen. Trade is gonna happen. Santa's gonna get picked by Strady. Almost gets one off the objective, but the squad spawns are coming in, and CR's gonna maintain control. Meanwhile, Shot's just gonna hang out in that Jeep. Not a bad idea, and the switch comes in. They're gonna try and push up to the top here, but I don't think it's gonna be enough, because now he's gonna... in a fight for his life. 50 health. Megatron. Can he do it? He's melting Medi. Medi is by himself, but the Aegis coming in are gonna save Medi. They ran out of countermeasures. There's nothing you can do about it. Santa got his hands full here on this objective. This is where all the action is gonna be for quite a while. CR's looking at a 100 ticket deficit here soon. They gotta make a play. They're gonna have to get their back flag back, which is exactly what they're doing. But nope, it's gonna get held. Not gonna be enough. Canister, one shot, one slap. Putin right there, knock him off the objective. And just gonna play a little bit of support. Let his infantry do his work for him right there. Get on the objective, get the burn. Meanwhile, CR making sure they try and get this double cap here to hold themselves back in the game. Again, they're looking at a 100 ticket deficit here, but they are gonna cap this objective. plenty of armor and infantry support, but in the meantime, REQ is making their push on their home flag. They have air superiority. Eddie right here trying to get a pick on the top. I don't know if he can get it, but it doesn't matter. Veda's going to help him out. One more guy on top. Motor going to sit in. Great use of the vehicles by REQ. Use these Jeeps. They got to watch out for these mines, though. CR, I mean, they're doing a great job. It's just, REQ's countering every time. It's just how you're supposed to play Conquest right there. It's a little lesson in the book. Their recap and their back cap, better get yours too, because they're gonna have to dedicate the same amount of people you are to cap yours. So, there's only so many people on the map, but here we go. We have ourselves a frontal is pushing up relatively hard right there. Santa's still alive in his tank. It's a bold move. Well, never mind. This is on the back flag objective. I thought he was pushing up on Bravo's. Woo. Charlie and Bravo. It's like, dang, he's pushing up relatively far. But hey, he's back here having to deal with these two rats, Diego and Zombie. Zombie with those back mines. I'm sure that Frontal knows this, and he's really trying to deal with this at this time. And he's just trying to get Diego. But Diego squirming and lizarding around. He's gonna miss the pick on Diego, and there's the medic still alive. Now he's gonna have to deal with it. He's gonna drive right down. Coming down into zigzag, it's gonna pick Diego, but Zombie trying to get a nade kill, trying to pull a rat trap out of the books. Well played, but it just didn't happen. He almost pulled it off. That might have been the biggest troll I have ever seen, if it was taken. Gotta hear the parachute. Got a mine down, but I don't think it's gonna be enough. He's gonna try and get this pick in corner. Nope, not gonna happen, and the mine remains. Igla's gonna keep that chopper suppressed. CR, back capping, doing what they do best. And here are the five people going to the back flag right now that Santa has to deal with. He's gonna have his hands full again. Exactly what I thought was gonna happen. CR, great infantry play right here. Now that they got their tank back, they can easily hold their back flag for one. Makes a little bit more of a threat for any infantry of REQ to push, and we're gonna see ourselves a little bit of a bleed here. Get CR back in the game. A lot of people on this objective, though. They don't even care about the tower, but not having the tower, it's gonna create some problems just simply for people parachuting. So REQ always has access to a back cap. So it's just something that they're gonna have to deal with. Medi's about to get smacked by an Igla right here. I don't know if he knows this. He's getting locked. Here it comes. It's gonna be too late. Ooh, got the mobility hit right around the corner. He's lucky right there. Got it off just in time. Almost dodged it. Great attempt by Medi. But Santa right here is gonna take a little bit of attention and focus it on the tank. Make sure that he's not pushing up. Good one shot right there. Get a good one tap on him. Make sure he knows, you know, he's there. It's all information. It's all great information. What? Looks like we have hold here. Megatron. Oh, and they get obliterated fatality with the triple Igla. Oh my Lanta, the rat strats are real. Uten getting spotted out by Medi. Gonna make him take that elevator back down to the first level. And it looks as though CR's just not gonna have anything on their back cap. They don't want anything happening. They're just gonna sit here. They don't want REQ to take their back cap at all. There he is, gets the spot on him, gets the knowledge, play passive. He's gonna go for a pick here. Now a 1v1 scenario, and he does get Diego with the long range shot. Diego got melted at range right there. Smart play, sit behind that cover, and negate that angle for Diego, because the last thing you wanna give him is a bigger target. And that play to his advantage right there, sitting behind that counter, getting that pick, great play, gotta hand it to him. It was a great shot. Not much Diego can do right there. His whole body is open to being shot. So it's a little bit of a one-sided fight. Either way, still a good play. Oh, Megatron trying to get off the small, almost gets it, but Medi dodging to the side. And here comes the zigzag, the classic jump to the left, jump to the right, trying to get a small off, not gonna happen. He's gonna go down. Megatron getting picked, and here comes Colt. He's going to try, and oh, he should have waited the angle ahead. He just missed his opportunity, and Marco Paz jumping down from the roof is going to pick him off. He had one chance. But it just wasn't in the cards. Furious here, going to revive his buddy. He's got one in front. Here he's got two in front. He's going to get melted by Invader. Got a two-on-two scenario. He's trying to get this revive up, but the double frag is good. He's going to pick up a one-piece. Almost picks up the two-piece, but the medkit's still staying in there. Here comes the deep end. Invader trying to pick up a two-piece, and Diego's right there as well. And Frontal, before he goes down, is going to take out Invader, but Diego is right there to clean it up. Great trades. That was a heated situation. There's not much you can do. Well played. But REQ's going to walk away with this one as well. 135 tickets to zero, possibly 134. The trades are real. Diego does have one in front. But Invader's going to help him out and take it out. One more in mid and one to the left. Can Diego survive? He gets one. He's got one pushing, and the game is going to end before he gets picked. Having a little bit of sweaty infantry play there. Got really excited. Great game. Fantastic game to watch. It just... what it boils down to right now, CR is playing their artists. They're contesting extremely well. They're countering the objectives extremely well. They're countering vehicles extremely well. But not having air superiority to clean off the tower resulted in REQ just being able to parachute down to the back cap constantly all game. And you can't compete with that. You just can't. I mean, the parachutes alone, I mean, it doesn't matter if you have both flags. I mean, if you can't hold them, if you can't hold those two flags and they just keep parachuting, not much you could do. There's just not much you could do at all. So, I mean, it's unfortunate for CR that that's something they're facing right now. I mean, honestly, the way I look at it, and I'm going to say this again, and for every team out there, look at the tower. Take down the tower if you don't want to cap it. You don't want people parachuting. If you level the tower, you get rid of the parachutes. CR stands a better chance of holding the back caps right there. And it becomes more of a confrontational engagement because everybody's on the ground. Nobody's parachuting anymore. You can't just parachute back to the back flag. Take the tower down and be aware that a tank does spawn. It does spawn on Chinese side. I mean, it's closer to the Chinese side than it is the American side, and that's where the tanks spawn. So, I mean, you can get an extra tank out of it. Might be something to look into rather than just having to deal with all these parachuters coming down all the time. I still have yet to see it. The only one time I have seen it is back when I played for EXP. We took down the tower and we got an extra tank out of it and then cleared. And then that was a base. So, I mean, it's just something for... I would like to see it put into play. Just going to throw that out there. It might be a little bit of a strategy to counter that parachuting. Because it is a pain to deal with. Let's jump in with Megatron and Fam. If I can move over, would be... oh my goodness, thank you. All right, Deferts. Here we are. Here we go. Map 2, right now, REQ is up by 135 tickets, so CR needs a huge win right here, and they're going to dedicate a full back cap immediately. They're just going to go straight forward. They're not even going to waste any time. Defert's going to the roof. Interesting strat. We didn't see this before. What am I doing? Okay, there we go. Go and do some damage here. Motor's going to get the pick on. Ouch. It looks like CR's chopper is going to go down. Invader with the Aegla kill is going to go ahead and take it out. There goes the air superiority. But CR with the early 2-cap right here, holding down the base objectives, their back cap, and REQ's at the same time as well. So now we'll see how REQ responds to this. Let's just go ahead and jump in at their home flag. Looks like Santa's just going to get focus fired right here. He's got a lot of RPGs to deal with, but Zombie right here coming in clutch, trying to help Santa out. Santa is disabled right now. He's going to get anti-bombed, and there goes the tank. Early tank kill for CR right here. They are coming out of the gates hot. They are going to go ahead and try to just get this early lead right now, right here. Not going to waste any time. They do have a lot of tickets. They do have a lot of tickets to make up, but it's only 135. If they can win by 135, they're looking at something good. But REQ right now on the back cap. on their back cap, fighting extremely hard. Frontal's just gonna try and play passive and hold this down. Doesn't see the Jeep sitting in front of Bravo. Unfortunate they didn't see it. That's an easy kill right there. And here comes CR, still holding down this back objective. Santa with one, but he's gonna get shot in the back by Megatron. Don't have a whole lot going on here for REQ. They're just gonna give up their back flag at this point. They're gonna try and focus something. They got a lot of people to deal with. Their infantry is gonna have to carry them on Charlie and try to get this tank whittled down to little health and hopefully get rid of it. Seems as though Frontal is gonna be at 50 health. Interceptor almost breaking his ankles, completely parachuting down there, but REQ is gonna have to try and figure something out to get rid of this tank, because that's the one thing that's keeping them from capping that back objective. They're trying, Ace Time trying to get some long range picks here, not gonna happen. Fallouts are gonna come in. Meanwhile, Santa's still trying to fight for this back flag. Invader's gonna go down by Turbo Putin using the M4, but Motor's here to help him in the Jeep. See what goes on. They do have mines down there. It's gonna be a 2-on-2 on this objective. Two people, here we go. Motor's gonna make the push in. They gotta watch out for these mines. They can be used against them here. One in middle, did they get the pick? No, they didn't. But Fatality with another triple Igla kill. Getting the triple kills today. That's his second of the day. See what Motor does here. He's just gonna jump down into the middle, see if he can get some callouts. He's gonna get the spot on one. Did he get the pick? No, he didn't. He's gonna re-peek. Diego's gonna pick up out, but Motor's gonna get shot by No Rage behind the pole. Interceptor still down here. For his team. He's got that big pack light. Looks like REQ's just gonna try and make this push down. He's got the one to the left. Suppressor, not gonna let him know he's there. Putin's gonna get picked, but he's got a guy behind. What's he gonna do? Can he get the hip fire? No, he can't. He's gonna get double teamed. Motor's gonna get wiped as well. CR making a huge play right there, anchoring that objective and wiping REQ on their home flag. Great play. Really trying to get this ticket lead, and they are by 80 tickets already early in the game. They're gonna try and make the switch here. Probably to RPGs now that the tank is up. They're gonna switch it. Combeat's just trying to get one hit, delay this tank from pushing up, but he's gonna get picked in the back by Yosu. Diego got one coming up the elevators, catches him off guard, using the G18, the GG18. Can't really go up against that with the primary, because it's better than any primary at close range. Meanwhile, Marco Boz getting smacked in the mouth with an RPG. That's unfortunate, it's gotta hurt. REQ's got to have a sense of urgency here, but they want to win this map. They want to shut it down here now. They got to have a sense of urgency there. Down to 164 tickets, and CR still has 130 tickets to go. Meanwhile, Frontal taking some RPGs, and there it is. There is the NG bomb right there. They finally got to sit down. Four people on the back half for CR. They got to hold this if they want to win. The trades are coming in. Invader and Motor going ahead to take out Yosuke. I don't think anybody's here. CR is parachuting in. They have one person to contest, but looks like REQ is going to go ahead and get this back cap. They're going to negate this ticket bleed. They're going to stop it right now. One more guy in car show still. Parachuting in. Got one in front. Can they get the pick? Defertz is just going to jump in and get melted. Didn't even fire a bullet. And they are. Now REQ is getting their back cap back. Santa said that enough is enough. I'm getting down here in the tank. Got a guy in the ice cream shop. Can he get him? He smacks Kinguin as he's jumping out. Got a guy to the left. He's going to get Stratty as well. Did they get the wipe, though? That is the real question. No, they did not. We still have infantry here for CR. They might be planning an attack. I'm not sure. Maybe if I can get out of here. Thank you. Two guys in. Santa's got to be careful here. He's got to be really careful not to get RPG in the back, but one, No Rage is going to get picked. An RPG coming out from Strady, but he's going to be chased down. He's going to be hunted like a madman. Can he survive? He gets one pick. He gets one guy pushing up. He gets the double. Strady anchoring it out for his team. He's got one more guy pushing back, but the squad spawn's coming in. Diego's going to pick one. Diego's going to pick two. Can he get the revives on his team? Yes, he does. Santa pushing in as well. Oh my goodness, the trades right now are real, but CR still holding on to the back cap. They have neutralized it, but Santa is now in here with the tank. He's gonna pose a huge threat, but RPGs, one, two, three. Can he get the picks? No, he's gonna have to back out, but he can't back out of here. He's got one way to go. It's a one way. He's gonna have to go in, but Diego with the two-piece. Marco Boz coming in with the trades. Yosuke still picking Marco Boz. The anchor is real. There's still three people left here for CR. The fight for their back cap is real. This is gonna determine the game. Can they get the picks they need? Oh my goodness! Santa getting the pick! He's anchoring it down for his team, but the RPGs are too strong. CR's presence here, huge. Five people on the objective. They need to get picks. They are losing it. This is a sense of urgency right now. REQ knows, and they have their whole team here. This is the fight for the game right now. Guys coming around the left. The hip fires, the trade. Zombie jumping back and forth. Hip fired by Kingwin. King's gonna get one, but face punch can knock it down another. Turbo Putin still up here. Can he hold it? Losing the objective, but now they are contesting. The chopper is in here as well. He's gonna have to deal with it. Gonna jump into the NRAP. Can they get the picks? No, he can't get in because face punches in. Oh my god, took away the spawn for him. He negated it, but he's gonna take some fire. He's gonna jump out. Mines are gonna come down. The trades are real. Face punch gets no rage. He's got one in front, but Ace Time's gonna pick off Straighty. And REQ just gonna, by sheer force and will, are gonna take this objective, and that is gonna be it. That is GG. Buy tickets. REQ just destroying and just overwhelming with spawns right here. Santa doing his best to stay alive underneath. It was looking grim. He's gonna get RPG'd from the right. It's not over yet. They're gonna fight tooth and nail for this objective. But Colt is gonna go back and try to get that home objective for his team. Frontal right here, knows he's got a guy in front. Gonna have to wipe him before they push up there. Otherwise, it's gonna be a long game. The whole team for CR now looking at the base. Three cap, almost had it there. Great attempt, but they have to deal with a triple cap, possibly a double cap. They don't have the tickets to come back. It is just gonna be an overwhelming sheer force. Now REQ is gonna pour it on. Megatron getting the picks they need, but Medi is here in the little bird, still causing a lot of problems. Can Frontal get the SWAT on Medi? No, Medi's gonna get a two-piece on the infies, but they're gonna get revived, and there goes the chopper. Or no, he's up on top of the building, repairing and switching. Ouch is out here trying to get the pick. It's not gonna happen. The parachute's coming in. He's gonna get overwhelmed on the car. The defib isn't real. Diego's gonna get shut down trying to be a troll. This is a no-troll zone, Diego. Please mind your manners. And Frontal getting absolutely anti-bombed. One from the back, tank from the side. He doesn't have AP, and he's gonna go down. Santa's gonna push up and make it a point to kill. The chopper is up for CR, but Medi has maintained air superiority. The hipfire by Zombie is gonna take out Yosuke right there. Running that CZ. And he's got a Jihad Jeep as well. Putting mines on there. He's trying to get a pick in this, but it's kind of hard to see. And Santa's gonna go ahead and take out Putin right there. And REQ is gonna take CR back like from them by sheer force. CR looking at a lot of adversity right now. It's unfortunate that they lost that huge fight on Alpha. That was the game-winning push right there, but REQ smelt blood in the water. They had to get it done, otherwise they stand a chance of going into a round three against this CR team, which shows that they know what they are doing. They're not to be messed with on the ground. Not to be taken lightly at all. This anti-bomb finally looks like Shots is gonna get taken out of his Jeep that he's been sitting in all game. Medi is here, gonna try and dodge these RPGs. He's gonna try and farm it before the game is over, and that's gonna be it. GG, REQ beats CR. Oh my Lanta, that A-flag fight was absolutely insane. But REQ is gonna walk away here. GG, guys, GG's to both teams, 2-0.